alcoholic liver disease. Alcohol is the most common cause for the cirrhosis of the liver. First of all, we need to know the safe limit of the alcohol. Safe limit of the alcohol is less than 28 unit in case of male, whereas less than 21 unit in case of female. Now this unit, we need to know how to find out this unit. Usually 1 unit of alcohol is equal to 8 gram of alcohol, and this 8 gram of alcohol is present in 40 ml of whiskey, 120 ml of wine, and 220 ml of beer. So this is the way to find out the safe limit of alcohol. Now one more point is should be remembered, that if a person is consuming 160 gram of alcohol per day for 8 years, it will increase the risk of cirrhosis. More than 160 gram of alcohol per day for 8 years, then this is the risk factor for cirrhosis of liver. Development of cirrhosis will increase by 6-fold if the safe limit of this drug safe limit has been doubled. If the suppose that the safe limit for a meal was 28 and a person drinks 2 times of the 28 unit, then the risk for the cirrhosis will increase by 6 times. So this was the third thing one should know in the association of the alcohol with the liver disorder. Now the pathophysiology. How does the alcohol cause liver disease? Look, the alcohol metabolism is via 3 mechanisms. And the first is and the largest amount of the alcohol undergoes the 80% of the alcohol undergoes oxidation by the alcohol dehydrogenase, and it changes the alcohol into acetaldehyde. This alcohol dehydrogenase changes CH3CH2OH ethanol into acetaldehyde, CHO group. Okay, and this CHO group has the capacity to adduct with the cellular protein and activate the immune system. This has the ability to activate immune system, whereas the remaining 20% of the alcohol gets converted into acetate by the help of cytochrome P2E, cytochrome CYP2E1. Okay, this converts the alcohol into acetate, and this acetate has the ability to produce oxygen free radical, and which causes mitochondrial damage and results into alcoholic liver disease. Mitochondrial damage, and which ultimately cause alcoholic liver disease. And some of the amount of alcohol gets absorbed via the gut. Almost 0 to 1% of the alcohol is absorbed by the gut, and which can activate the Kupffer cell, in which results in inflammatory response from the liver, and this inflammation results in the alcoholic liver disease. This gets absorbed from the gut, okay, and activates the Kupffer cell. So these were the 3 mechanisms by which the alcohol is metabolized and causes liver disease. Now the clinical picture. The clinical picture of the alcoholic liver disease can be of three variant, means the most good prognostic disease or early resolution disease will be simple alcoholic fatty liver disease. Fatty liver. The second may be alcoholic hepatitis, or the third component is cirrhotic type of alcoholic cirrhosis. Look, the fatty liver has the best prognosis and it usually resolves after 3 months. There is a spontaneous resolution seen in this patient after 3 months of alcohol abstinence, means when the person stops taking alcohol after 3 months, the fatty liver is recovered and it has the best prognosis of alcohol abstinence. Okay, now coming to the alcoholic hepatitis. Usually they present with jaundice, as we studied earlier. The alcoholic or any type of hepatitis has pre-icteric, icteric and post-icteric, and the complication can be portal hypertension and present with jaundice. And it has bad prognosis in relative to the fatty liver disease, and the patient usually has acute alcoholic hepatitis often deteriorates during first 1 to 3 weeks, and the resolution period is about 6 months. Okay, then coming to the last and the worst prognostic disease of the alcoholic liver disease, very bad prognosis, because only 50% of the people survive for about 5 years of age. You should always remember that 50% people only survive, the survival rate is 5 years in 50% of the people, and they often present with variceal bleeding, ascites and hemorrhoid. Their complaint will be variceal bleeding or ascites. Okay, and now coming to the prognosis, means for the investigation of alcoholic liver disease, it is exactly similar to the cirrhosis of the liver. So for the investigation, we can send the liver function test, blood examination and imaging, means LFT, blood examination. Under LFT we will look for the bilirubin, prothrombin time, AST ALT ratio, ALP enzyme, and other protein and albumin level in the blood will be seen. And in the blood examination, we will look for the leukocytosis and lymphocytosis, which is usually not present, but the cellular count is decreased in case of liver disease. And other imaging can also be sent for the diagnosis of the cirrhosis. Okay. Now the prognosis. The prognosis of the alcoholic liver disease is by the help of Madrey score or discriminant function. This is by Madrey score, or it is also called as discriminant function. And it is usually obtained by a formula of 4.6 into patient's prothrombin time. Patient's prothrombin time minus control prothrombin time. Control prothrombin time. Then we will add the bilirubin level. Okay, this is the Madrey score or discriminant function. If it is greater than 32, then this has a very worst prognosis. It implies that there is severe liver disease present in this patient, and usually they need to undergo corticosteroid therapy. They need corticosteroid therapy, or there is one more modality that can be pentoxyphylin can be given. Pentoxyphylin. So this is the significance of Madrid score. This signifies very poor prognosis. And if it is less than 32, we will go for the conservative treatment, that is abstinence of the alcohol and nutritive support to the patient. And nutritive support can be given by good nutrition and enteral feeding via fine bore nasogastric tube in severely ill patient may also be needed. Okay, these are the modality of treatment in alcoholic liver disease. Thank you.